Basic concept of pre-stress. Hi everyone, this is De La Cruz, engineering video tutorial. And in this video, we will talk about pre-stress. Okay, so we will not talk here about the methodology of how is pre-stress being done. We will talk about the purpose of the pre-stress and the basic concept. Okay, so let's start. So let's consider a simply supported beam, and lalagyan natin niya ng load dyan, and that will deflect in that manner because of that load. Okay, now one of the design criteria in designing a structure is the serviceability. Okay, now, serviceability, we are tackling about the deflections and cracks of beams or any structures. Okay, now in order to minimize the deflection, dito ginagawa yung pre-stress. Okay, so let's consider this animation. Lalagyan yan ng pre-stress at that point, and that is below the neutral axis and at a certain distance, offset distance, eccentricity. Okay, and because of that P, it will induce a moment about the neutral axis that is basically the P times E. Okay, so ito yung direction ng moment dyan, and the same dito. That is the moment about the neutral axis due to the pre-stress. And that moment will bend the beam, paganyan, okay? It will bend the beam downward. Okay, now if ibabalik natin yung load dyan, it will somehow balance the deflection lang, or somehow i-eliminate niya. So hindi naman necessarily na ma-eliminate talaga yung deflection, but it will limit the deflection, the excessive deflection. Okay, so that's the basic purpose. So of course that pre-stressing force is mag-a-add yan ng strength ng ating beam in terms of shear, and of course in terms of flexural stress. Okay, so finally we will be computing the stresses due to these loads, due to this pre-stress load and the external loads alone, including the beam weight. Okay, so ganito yan. So let's consider a rectangular cross section lang, and the that is the neutral axis, and ayun, yung P is mag-a-act dyan, the pre-stressing force. Now, let's focus on this. Okay? Because of this load P, if that will act at the centroid of this cross-section, it will cause a uniform stress dyan. Okay? That is assumed na P natin is ilalagay natin sa centroid ng cross-section, and since that P is a compressive force, let's assume that is going to the right yung stresses. I mean, going to the left yung stresses. Okay? That is just the simple stress lang. Negative P divided by this cross-sectional area. Okay? So, let's be mindful sa sign convention, because this is very critical in pre-stress problem. So, compression is negative and tension is positive. Now, the graphical representation naman, let's use na lang na going to the left is compression and going to the right is tension. Okay, now because of this moment, it will also induce a flexural stress, or what we call the bending stress. Okay, so recall the formula of the bending stress, that is the my over I. Okay, or sometimes natawag na mc over I. Okay, now the dilemma here is how to identify which portion of the beam will be in tension and in compression because of this moment. Okay, so ganito yan. So, tingnan nyo yung direction ng moment. Ito is iikot pa ganyan. And this will push the beam dito sa ibaba. Therefore, the portion of the beam that is below the neutral axis will be in compression because pinupush niya yan. Now, dito naman, above the neutral axis, is hihilahin ng moment. Kaya magiging tension dyan. Okay? So, if you cannot imagine that well, so, ito yung tandaan nyo, design convention. The moment that will tend to bend the beam upward will cause a compression stress at that fiber and the tension stress at the bottom fiber. Okay? Otherwise, baliktad naman. The moment that will tend to bend the beam downward, the top fiber will be in tension and the bottom fiber will be in compression. Okay? But in this case, it will tend to bend the beam downward. So, ganito yung scenario niya. So, the top fiber will be in tension and the bottom fiber will be in compression. Okay. So, let's proceed. So, the stress diagram due to the moment is ganito yun. So, the top fiber will be in tension. So, that will be going to the right. Okay. And that is due to the bending stress, My over I. So, general formula ng bending stress. And the bottom fiber will be in compression, so going to the left. And that is negative My over I, so negative for compression. Okay. And for bending stress, the stress distribution will be linearly changing. Okay. Ganito yan, always sa bending stress. Okay. Now, ito yung neutral axis where the stress due to bending is zero. Now, finally, we can compute the critical stresses of the beam, which is obviously is at the outermost fibers of the beam, the top and the bottom fiber. Okay? So, the stress at the top fiber, sabi natin eta, that is just the summation of stresses. So, here the stress here is negative P over A, take note that is uniform, plus the My over I. So, let's be specific, that is the moment due to pre-stress, My over I. And the bottom fiber naman, let's focus on the bottom side. So, ganito lang yan. So, negative MPRY over I. Okay? And take note that is just the stresses due to pre-stressing force. Okay? Hindi para sali yung loads dyan. Yun. So, let's proceed to the situation. Okay, a 6 meters long cantilever beam. So, this statement here is, ito lang yun. Nagsasabi na ito yung beam natin, kind of the beam. This cantilever beam that is overhanging and the pre-stressing force 640 kilonewtons. So, let's proceed for number 1, for part 1. Determine the stress at the bottom fiber at the free end. If the center of the gravity distance coincides with the centroid of the section. So, ano yung ibig sabihin niya? This is the cross section. This will be the neutral axis. The strands now coincides with the centroid of the cross section. So, that it does mean that the pre-stressing force is acting at the centroid lang. Okay? Now, take note, sinabi niya, at the free end, ano yung stress at the free end dito? Okay? So, that is just P over A, since wala yung eccentricity. Okay? Hindi yan mag-create ng moment. And that is just negative 5.12 MPa. Okay? So, the load here will not cause any moment here because that is free. Oh, ganun yan. That, it might be the question in the board exam. Okay, so let's proceed for number 2. Determine the stress at the top fiber at the fixed end if the center of the gravity distance is 100 mm above the neutral axis. Now, ito daw. Yung pre-stressing force daw is acting at certain distance 100 mm from the neutral axis. So, if we look at this at the side view, ganito, ikat lang natin dito. Ito yung pre-stressing force. 100 mm. Okay? So, ano yung stresses daw? Take note, sinabi dyan na at the top fiber at the fixed end. Dito yung pinisipay ng problem. So, the stress here, unahin natin yung pre-stress. So, the pre-stressing force will create a uniform stress dyan. That is due to P. Let's call that P over the cross-sectional area. Now, take note that will create a moment. Ganyan. Okay? So, that is just basically the P times E. Okay? So, the sign convention is here. Nalagay ko dito. Parang, take note, ito is ibabend niya upward yung beam. So, this will be the case. Okay? The top fiber, because of that moment, will be in compression and tension naman sa ibaba. Okay? So, ito yung stress distribution. That, take note, the top fiber will be in compression. So, going to the left, and that is MPRY over I. And the bottom fiber will be in tension, positive naman sa ibaba. Ito yung stress distribution. Okay. Now, we are to look, solve the stress at the top fiber. So, let's focus on the top. So, the stress at the top fiber is just negative P over area. 640,000. Gawin natin newtons yan. Okay. Divided by area, the area is 250 times 500. So, square, a rectangular section na yan. And plus the MPRY over I. So take note, the moment is P times E, that is 640,000 times 100, the eccentricity. Ano yung Y? The distance from the neutral axis to the desired point. So the desired point is dito sa top fiber. So that is just half of the 500. Divided by the inertia of the rectangle, that is BD cube over 12. So BD cube over 12. Okay? So, take note, we have in a uniform load here. So, i-account pa natin yung stress due to that uniform load. Okay? Take note, the stress to be solved is at the fixed end. So, kukunin natin yung moment dito. It will create a reaction moment dyan. Tawagan natin moment at A. So, the moment at A, that is just 5 times 6 times half of the 6, the moment, 90 kilonewtons meter. Okay? Now, if you will imagine, this load will tend to bend the beam downward. So, the top fiber will be in tension, the bottom fiber will be in compression. Okay? So, ganito yung mangyayari dyan. Top fiber will be in tension, MAY over I, in compression as baba. And this is the stress distribution. So, again, i-add pa natin ito dito because that is at the top fiber. And ito yung signifies the stress at the fixed end. Okay? So, that is just MY over I. So, 90, gawin natin newtons millimeter. So, 90 times 10 raised to 6. Again, Y is 250 and the same moment of inertia. Okay? From here, lalabas na answer is negative 2.624 MPa. Ayun. So, sa calculator nyo, medyo mahaba-haba to. So, pwede natin isa-isahin yan. I-solve mo muna to. Then, ito. And ito. Then, i-add lahat. Okay? Now, for the medyo advanced dyan, pwede natin itong gamitin. The maximum bending stress for rectangular section. Okay? Pwede natin itong i-substitute dito. Kasi ito yung basic formula talaga. Okay? So, gagamitin na lang natin ito sa question number 3. How about for question number 3? Determine the eccentricity of the pre-stressing force at the fixed end such that the resulting stress at the top fiber of the beam at the fixed end is zero. So, it just simply says that the top stress, I mean the stress at the top fiber is zero. Ano yung kakailanganin natin eccentricity E? Okay? So, variable yung E. So, ito lang yun. The top fiber is just the summation of the stresses at the top. The same solution from part 2. Okay? So, ito, negative P over area. Okay? Follow lang. Then, plus the negative of, gamitin na natin to for rectangular cross-section lang ito ha. 6M. So, take note, the M here, dito, sa pangalawang diagram is the pre-stressing moment. So, P, that is 640 times E. Express in E, then BD squared, that is 250 yung B, ang D is 500 squared. Okay? And lastly, ito, 6M over BD squared. Red. Okay? So, as you see, ang unknown dito is the eccentricity E na lang. And using our calculator, E must be 57.3 millimeters. So, yun. So, that's it. I hope naintindihan nyo yung presentation natin. And sa hindi pa nakapag-subscribe, please subscribe my channel and like and share my videos. Thank you everyone and stay safe. God bless.